these people to be in their corner. So as a foster parent, your job is to provide safe and loving homes. If the child has been abused emotionally, sexually, mentally, you want to take steps to help that child become better and not add on to it. You also, if they lost a loved one, or if they lost a loved one, then you help them grieve to let them know that their family may be gone, but they're not. God help them keep remembering where they came from. Don't make them forget their past, because their past is part of them. Job as the social worker, or the office of the social worker, is to screen families, make sure that the families have the proper place for the child. Running water, heat, windows, place for the child to stay, to have the money without the check to take care of the child in the first place. Also, they can clean the background, so say you were a stupid kid and you got a DUI when you were 20. That's on your permanent record now. So when you go to want to be a foster parent, they may not let you become one because you were reckless with your life. What's the point of your reckless with a child's life that's not even your own? They are supposed to screen these families, but there are ways to get through cracks. Obviously, we have problems, so there are ways to get through these cracks. Ways are foster care. So group homes are the number one place kids go. And in a group home, it's usually one family taking care of multiple kids that they have in their care. Now, the family could be the nicest family in the world, take care of the kids, love them, treat them like home. But the kids in the home may not necessarily be the same way as the family that holds the home. The kids could have bully newcomers, or the family could look nice on the outside, but that's only for when the social worker is there, and then as soon as they leave, they return to their own ways, barely beating a child probably, locking the child up, beating the child. Who's to say what happens in the house, because a social worker only visits the house once a week. But we put so many caseloads on the social worker that they're stressed in, and sometimes they miss. And what they miss, they don't know, and what they don't know, they can't help a child get. And 9 times out of 10, when a child gets hurt, they don't tell because they feel like they probably told once in their lifetime and they were told you're lying. And once a child gets told that once and they tell someone else and they keep being told you're lying, they're going to stop telling. Because they don't need nobody to believe them. So these are the different types. Name a few you have who or can blood related. Now, that's what they try to find first, but some families' members won't take in a child because of blood between the parents. Or you have the non-related kin, friends or families, teachers, coaches, people who have been closely into the child's life from the very beginning. They try to keep them there until they find a permanent residence. You also have a home for kids who have special needs who need the health care provided, but not someone who loves them can provide for them, so they have a special home for them too. These are the types of abuse and neglect and foster care. So one of the main ones today is child abuse and sex trafficking. Some foster parents or parents themselves will try to sell their kids and make money off of it, but not knowing what their kids are doing. It could be their sex trafficking ring. It could be literally anything, and these people don't care what happens to the kid as long as they get that check. Now, there are some good things about foster care. Not everything about foster care is bad. One is you get to help a teen crossing from childhood. Like, you have a teen who's been in foster care their whole life, and those are the least likely to get adopted. When people go to foster care, they want to adopt from toddler to preteen so that they have, like, a connection that's not too hard to change from where they've been living. And if you adopt a teen, it is harder to connect with them, but it's not impossible if you do it the right way. And this is a good way to wonderful because you can help that child find jobs, resources, help them know that they can go to college and that they have the resources available if they just look and ask for help. Another one is you get to have a child give a new perspective on life and change, show them that not everything is a bad thing, and show them that people can love you, there is no end, it ends with their value. Financial records and all that, but you need to look at mental records, past experiences, and yes, they do have references, but references can lie. I could put my mama down and say she was my boss, and she was a good worker, and she came in time on everything, I could be at home sleep, and then be none the wiser, because they just have that person words to go off of. They need to do a more extensive look into the person. Foster families need resources. Now, they have classes for teaching how to become a good foster parent, but that's not all they need. They need like a support group of foster parents to talk to. They need to have that social worker that's available with them, and the only way that we can do that is if we put more funding into the foster care system. Because caseworkers, social workers have minimum of 5 cases to more on their desk a day. They have to take every one of them houses and make sure the child is safe, and things slip through crack. Kids get hurt and they don't tell, or they run away and because they feel like they weren't doing their job or somebody didn't care. Support the caseworkers, social workers. Just one way. We need to hire more people, but when you hire people, they need to know that when you come into this job, there is little to no money in social work. You make less than $180,000 a year being a social worker. And you're on salary. That you have bills to pay, student loans, all that. There's little to no money left. They need to educate the public. Because most people only know about the good side of foster care, or some know the negative aspects having been through it themselves. But we need to educate people on their ways that you can help the foster care system. And volunteer, honestly. You can volunteer anywhere. I was a volunteer social worker's aide over the summer of my junior year, and it was honestly one of the best times. We got to help a little girl who had met her from her mom not taking care of her. We took her to the beauty salon, and we got her hair cut. She felt all pretty and was smiling. It was an awesome experience. You will feel great if you help out. In conclusion, we need to change the foster care system, because it is structured right, but there's so many rules and regulations in the social care that stop good people, even though they have done something stupid in the past, for being a good family. That stupid person you could have stopped, that you stopped, could have been the one that changed a child's life, or multiple children's life. You never know where you're stopping from doing somebody.